impressed with a major difference. My last video, I debuted the telephone headset mic, and as you can see, I have an extremely high-tech mounting apparatus here. It's so high-tech. It's extremely high-tech. And I have added a windscreen. Oh, for those of you who didn't watch the last video, you really should, girl, because it's a good one. She's nice and tingly. But I introduced this microphone, which is a vintage 1950s or 1960s telephone that I wired a mic input into. So it has this very distinct, crunchy, almost telephone-like quality to it. Anyway, today we're going to be doing some beer tasting. Now, I already had one, as you may be able to see by my slight blush. I've already had one, and I quite enjoyed it. It was a White Claw. What I did, girl, is I went down to my local Giant. And I went to the clearance section, and sometimes, if you're lucky, they have these bags of beer that are like things that are about to expire, or ones that got broken up, or stuff that just didn't sell, I guess. And it's like $1 a beer, sometimes less if you're lucky, but I'll get into that later. Anyway, this was in it. This was a Blackberry White Claw. Pretty good. Pretty tasty, only 100 calories. I can't say that I like White Claw, but I dislike it less than I dislike beer. Now, you may have looked at the title of this, girl, and you're saying, well, girl, if you dislike beer, why are you doing a beer tasting? Well, one, I ran out of ideas. Two, I have this beer here. I like to get drunk, girl, and dollar beer hits the spot sometimes. Okay, so I've never had this brand before. It's brewed in Mexico. It's called Cerveza Pacifico Clara. Looks very nice. It says it's an imported beer. Doesn't tell me anything else about it, though. 143 calories, only 4.4% alcohol by volume. And girl, if I'm drinking a beer, I like it to be at least 8%. This is like half of a beer to me, but some people like things light, so here we go. I will bear in mind that these are room temperature, and a lot of beers taste like piss at room temperature. A lot of beers also taste like piss when they're cold, so I think this is a fairly neutral test. I do enjoy beer mixed with lemonade and some ice cubes. That's generally how I enjoy the beer. So that may be what I'm gonna do with the rest of these when I'm done. Oh, that is a beer, isn't it? It reminds me, has kind of a bitter aftertaste, actually. Nice and bubbly, tastes kind of like grain. But yeah, a slightly bitter aftertaste. I don't know how I feel about the Pacifico. I wouldn't drink it, except I have like 4 more of them. Get through it somehow. Pacifico. Clearly not sponsored, girl. If a seltzer company would like to sponsor me, that would be great, because I can like drink seltzer with a straight face and claim to enjoy it. The same cannot be said of beer, darling. Ugh. Not very good. Really not very good. Tastes a little bit like corn, actually. Yeah, kind of like corn water. Yeah, with just a bitter aftertaste. It's not doing it for me, girl, but luckily we have another one. We got another one. We got filter really, really improves the quality of this mic, because you're not getting all the wind, girl. You're not getting all the wind. She's catching all the wind. Hold on, I have to burp. My apologies to all my viewers' incredibly offended sensibilities. I know that offended you greatly. Anyway, this next beer is from the Kindred Spirit Brewing Company. It's called Headspace. And it's got a picture of a man on there. Could be a woman. Can't determine the sex of this individual. Their gender is, however, beer. And it looks like their head is being filled up with beer. And girl, I can relate. It says it's an India pale ale, rich and juicy with mosaic and citra. I don't know what mosaic is, other than the kind of tiling. And I don't know what citra is. Maybe it'll tell me. Nope, it won't tell me. You know, this one, at least, is 7.7% alcohol, so it'll at least be a little bit more effective than the Pacifico. It's got a nice matte kind of metallic label. It's really nice packaging. I don't hate it at all. It comes with some directions, and I'll read them out loud to you. Keep cold. Well, we've blown it. Keep cold. Enjoy fresh. Well, as opposed to, like, been out for a day, yeah. In a clean glass, as opposed to one you just pissed in, girl. Drink craft responsibly. Oh, yes, I shall be drinking responsibly. I shall be drinking for your tingles tonight. You're very welcome. It's just my bit of community service, really. All right, here we go. She's foaming a bit, foaming at the mouth a bit. Oh, I like the smell of this one much more. I like this one already. It smells fruity, girl. It smells fruity. Yeah, I like this one a lot more. It's quite a bit fruity. It's not fruity in the same way that a seltzer is fruity, but it's fruity in the way that a beer can be fruity. I suppose that would be the citra. Whatever a citra is, it sounds like citrus, and that's what I'm getting from this. It still has that dark beer note, but I don't even hate this. I hate to say it, but if I had to drink a beer, I'd drink this one. It's pretty good. I also appreciate that it comes in the tall boy can, because it makes my hands look more petite. That one's actually quite good. Yeah. Damn. I'm gonna finish that one. And then we have some bullshit that was also in the bag. So here's the thing. I thought I was getting a really good deal, because they were like, frickin' 10 beers in this bag, mate. Frickin' 11 beers in this bag, mate. But it turns out that three of them are non-alcoholic beer. And girl, what's the point? What's the point? You might as well be drinking kombucha and it would taste better. So, okay, this one is a non-alcoholic special effects IPA. What's special about it? Well, the special effects IPA is packed with all the bright citrusy notes of a classic IPA that just so happens to be non-alcoholic. Well, I can't relate, girl. Let's open her up. Smells almost floral, actually. Oh, I don't. It's really nasty. Yeah, I'm almost getting a floral. It's not not as citrusy as the headspace. It's not really as citrusy as the headspace. It's giving, like, fresh mown grass. You know what I'm saying? It's, almost like a vegetable-y note. It's, not pleasant. And if it were not going to get me drunk, I mean, it's not going to get me drunk, so I'm not going to finish it. I'm not even going, I might mix it with something later, but, girl, the only reason I drink beer is to get drunk. Not very good. Let's try the other one. One more. I hope that gave you tingles. Alright, this one is a non-alcoholic special effects hazy IPA. Girl, the beer. I'm sorry, I'm drinking carbonated beverages and I cannot be asked to edit out my burps. Not until I'm monetized, girl. Special effects hazy IPA is full of the bombastic aromas and juicy finish of a hazy IPA. That just so happens to be non-alcoholic. It says it's soft, surprising, and ripe. Ripe. Okay. This one tastes almost exactly the same as the last one. It's just like the worst soda you've ever had. Next. Girl, I don't even know why I'm bothering to finish this last one, because it's the same shit. It's non-alcoholic beer. I'm not going to like it. This one claims to be a Pilsner, whatever that means. Special effects pills is a crisp, snappy, remarkably refreshing brew that just so happens to be non-alcoholic. Oh, I got some foam on my nose. This one smells better than the last one. And it's less offensive, but I still don't like it. Yeah, I mean, it's just like a shitty soda, you know? It's really just, this one reminds me of the more expensive beers that I tend to go for with a higher alcohol content and a slightly darker tone. That's not to say I won't still make a face at that one, girl, because, again, the baseline is just like, I don't like beer. I just don't like beer. I like getting drunk. I don't like beer. I like wine. I genuinely enjoy wine. Mixed drinks, girl, you can make it taste like whatever you want. Delicious. Beer always kind of tastes like this to me. And it's so many calories, and like, the most effective way to get drunk is just to mix vodka with sugar-free soda for me.